Hello everyone, welcome back to the Binding of Isaac, blah blah blah. I want to do the daily. This run's going to be completely out of order because I'm probably going to upload it sooner rather than later. Basically, I'm not going to wait until I've got through the backlog that I did a couple of weeks ago just to upload this daily. This is probably the fourth one we have to win in a row. It's been a while since I did a daily at all, so I'm not actually sure how far through that old... Oh, that was bad. How far through the five daily challenge we have got, but I think it's four or so. Maybe this is the fifth one, but I definitely did the third one, so I should be okay. This is not an XL floor, so taking that damage isn't so bad. Apart from the fact that it's really terrible damage on the first floor. Yeah, I just put Brian out after giving him a whole bunch of catnip treats, so that's going to be fun for him. He won't eat. I mean, maybe he just doesn't like the food that we bought him, which is fair enough. I don't like a lot of the food I get bought. But he's a cat, so he doesn't have the luxury of being fussy. This ghost pepper is actually a fairly okay item, in my opinion. So yay for that. I've forgotten how to commentate on these games, so I think we're just going to play, see where the wind takes us. We have 13 cents already, thanks to some very lucky money happenings in the previous previous room, which gave us 2 nickels from something that we could access by shooting a fire rather than requiring us to spend a bomb to get to it. So this room is great because of the 2 lucky pennies, but also kind of irritating. Did I not just open that chest? Run away. No, I didn't. I opened a sack. We'll see if we can get some more, more cash. No more cash. Let's reroll that. Okay, we revealed the blue candle into the black candle, which is excellent. We didn't spend a key to get into that shop. Probably not ideal. You maybe wanted to use the hermit card to get out of something you don't want to do, rather than just get into the shop straight away. But we are going to Mega Satan, so we do want to get a bit of a press on here. Let's just leave and not fight these things, but I do want this money or whatever it's got for us. We also have the left hand, for some reason, as a starting trinket. I don't think I picked it up. Did I pick it up? I don't think I picked it up. So we started with the left hand, which means we're going to be getting a lot of red chests. I think I'd like to see where that goes. An alternative there, of course, is simply to get rid of it at the first available opportunity, although that might not be something that comes up because maybe we don't get given the opportunity to replace it. It could be a curated run. I don't know. We'll see where it goes. Obviously, deal with the devil. No. Well, yes, deal with the devil, but that wasn't what I was thinking of. Mega Satan fight does kind of mean we want to do Hush if we can, which means we're going to have to be strong enough to do Hush, or defensible at least enough to survive Hush. I'd rather go with strong enough, because defensible enough implies we're going to be taking a lot of damage and recovering from it, which is going to cost us points. It is a daily, but as previously noted, I would rather win these dailies than necessarily rank well, because we need to win 5 dailies, not in a strict row, but the 5 dailies we play, we have to win without failing one. I'm going to sneeze. Oh, Gordon Bennett. Oh, dearie me. Lords and mercy. It wasn't fair. Now, one of these is a library. Probably this one. I should have known that straight away. So we'll take these all for the bookworm transformation. Straight up, no worries. And I think what we do is actually re-roll this library here, which has given us a black heart, which I'm super happy with. We re-roll this library, and if we find a battery charge, we will use it and re-roll the library again, because that's going to be 9 books we get out of the rotation. We do have to pick them all up and put them down again, but you know, it's probably worth the points that will cost us to get all those books out of the rotation. And if we do find another library later, which is more likely because we have now picked up a book, we have that much extra opportunity to re-roll it into an item room, which is how libraries work, as far as I know. Unless they've nerfed that as well, in which case, what are you doing? Please bring back good old Isaac. But we will see if we want to reroll anything here first. I'm sorry if I'm sniffing a lot. I've had a cold over the past couple of days. You know how you get sore throat, then you get horrible cold. You know, you get the I don't want to get out of bed sort of sore throat because you can't breathe in the morning. Then you get the horrible sniffles. Do you know what? These are actually books that I'm happy to get out of the rotation. Especially with the Satanic Bible giving us a second Black Heart from the same room, which is super duper. Doesn't really bother me that we don't get to re-roll the item room. It's not that big of a deal. This... please be money. It was money. I would like to buy this. Even though... oh, I was going to say even though we could have bought the battery charge, which we could have done anyway. I think the Strength card is slightly better than the Empress card because of the way we can use it on a deal with the devil. So that is 9 books out of our rotation. We've got another Spirit Heart out of this. So I'm a fan of that. Did you see how the Book of Revelation gave us a 4.3% better chance of the deal with the devil? Which implies to me it gives you, you know, about a 10% better chance? Approximately 10% better chance than you already have? 10 percentage points? No. 10% better chance. Yeah. We have to do it because of the point value of it, but we don't really want to use Undefined because we may end up in an error room and therefore stuck. Oh, this is bad. Don't do that. Stuck in the inability to finish the rest of the floor. Oh, Undefined is great on a normal run, and if I could remember how to play the game, we would be doing a lot better than we are not taking damage. But I do remember not to use things like Undefined on a daily run, because you want to get as many points as you can by doing as many floors as you can, even if that's to your ultimate detriment. I do like the Bookworm transformation. Having the occasional 20-20 shot is going to be useless if we actually find 20-20, but... and I am aware that if we just wait for this thing to show its face, it will be easier to kill. But I don't think it has the same reticence to show its face as the hosts do. So I guess we just keep shooting it. This is a bother. Much better. Gulp. We swallowed our trinket. We can never get a not red chest, so that's fun. I'd like to regurgitate that trinket if you don't mind. Cupid's arrow doesn't really cut it. There's better things in here. If we take the prayer card and put it back, we'll get the HP out of it and then take the D6 with us. Being able to use bombs and or money to reroll that means that at least we can keep our reroll for something that doesn't have a reroll machine, e.g. the boss fight. Which I'd like to find at a slightly more appropriate juncture, because the more rooms we do without finding the boss fight to reroll, basically the more of an overcharge. How many times are you going to fire? More of an overcharge we get on the D6, the more wasted rooms there are. I mean, I guess you could argue that what we do is we actually go down here and use the D6 to reroll that. No, take Holy Mantle. Okay, good. Well, we didn't need to waste another bomb on that, because that was absolutely worth it. I do wonder whether the pool of items that the D6 rerolls you around is the same as the pool of items that the item room's own reroll would reroll you around. E.g., or i.e., or fardida, if you had rerolled that room with the reroll pedestal, would it have given me the same item? Because somehow I rerolled into Holy Mantle, which basically guarantees us a win on this floor. I think I will not do any shenanigans with the two hearts right now. If we lose enough HP that we want the two hearts, then we've got bigger problems, to be honest. Whoa, careful. Just an interesting question, I suppose. In my opinion. Okay, so we're not going to be able to reroll the boss fight because there's no rooms left on this floor for some reason. But there you go. Super short floor. So we're hoping for something that we want to just take, I suppose. We're also hoping for a deal with the devil, because we're also always hoping for a deal with the devil, but can't get everything. Can't always get what you want. But just sometimes, you just might get what you need. That was an amazing shot. We will not take that just now, in case this is extremely valuable, which I think it might be. Do you take the void? That's the thing. I mean, I know the pact is amazing, and the void is essentially free, so I mean, you pick it up anyway, and take the pact for no coins, but did you use the void to take the d6? I think you might do. Because now we have the void, which we can use to void anything else that we care to as well. I think I will take the HP, because we're going to have an HP anyway. It's not like we have permanent polar or invincibility at this stage. So, more devil fodder. It's probably worth the effort. Of course, immediately we can't get into the boss trap room as a result of having done that, but I guess that's okay. We can probably find something to give our HP to. Hopefully a Demon Judgment or at least a Blood Bank. Range up is fine. It's not a detrimental pill. Yes. Okay, I mean, this run is fine, but you have to imagine that it's fine for everybody else as well. Unless you took sufficient damage on an early floor to not get the first deal with the devil, which gave us the mark. If you didn't re-roll the blue candle into the black candle, that could either put you behind or ahead, depending on what curses you get not having the black candle. But honestly, I'm not sure there's really anything that could have scuppered us too much, except for maybe Curse of the Maze or something, causing us to take too long or sending us to a room we don't want to be in or something like that. Taking that guilt pill was interesting. We're very likely to get the guppy transformation as a result. But I think I would like the occasional, you know, old-fashioned chest. When you go to Mega Satan, there's no actual indication as to whether you're going via the chest or via the dark room. Now, I think originally in daily runs, you would go via the dark room in all cases, but I think they've changed that so that sometimes you do end up going to the chest. Will you pop up so that I can shoot you? It's very frustrating. And then, of course, I fail to actually kill you in the allotted time. Apologies for that. Sorry that I don't meet your very exacting standards. I haven't got any bombs. I've used a lot of bombs, but it's been a while since I did. And we have yet to receive a new one. Plenty of spirit hearts. Of course, because we're getting nothing but red chests. I mean, if I don't get the guppy transformation out of all these red chests, I'm going to be slightly salty. Not heck of salty, but kind of slightly salty. I've just realised the problem with absorbing the D6 is that you can't actually use it. So, well done me for that. But I mean, I'll absorb that. Gives us range and shot speed, which is not my favourite two stats to have increased, but at least we increased some stats, so there's that. Our rate of fire is already capped out, so I don't think we can improve that without something that breaks it, like Skinny Odd Mush, I think, is one of the things that we'd be looking for in that situation. Greed won't last long enough to hurt me twice. Hurt me once, shame on you. Hurt me twice, shame on me. Plenty of cash. The cash is, of course, points, and points mean prizes. In here, we have HP. Honestly, I don't really want it. I'm fairly sure that the void absorbs the item before the D6 re-rolls it. And I am going to have a little bit of a look around for an arcade, by the way. The reason I say that is that if we try to suck up an item that is passive, because we don't want the item, but we do want the chance at some good stat upgrades. We don't want to re-roll the item into an active item and then accidentally absorb that into our void, because we didn't see what it was and therefore have no idea what to do with ourselves. We would rather just have the stats. So, doesn't look like we'll be getting a re-roll anytime soon. I'm expecting that this is the only opportunity for a secret room. I mean, I don't mean a re-roll, I mean a charge on the item. I'm basically thinking I would like to absorb the HP that I don't want to take, turn it into some form of statistical benefit. But instead, we're just going to go down to the next floor without a deal with the devil to our name. Alas. And I was thinking that if I re-rolled the HP before I took the HP, yeah, I think that's good enough to take. I mean, I assume that voiding it would also help, but we did get a damage upgrade. It says all stats up, but when you're one of the stats is capped, it's hard to know whether that's actually lying to you or not. But all stats up is always health up, so we would like to get rid of this at some point, I think. Honestly, I don't know whether not having HP is beneficial to us on this run, because, you know, usually I early on, whilst playing Isaac, became enamoured with the idea of not having any red hearts by the time you get to the womb. especially if the run's good enough to support running on Spirit Hearts like this one certainly is, i.e. we have to get hit twice to suffer any damage at all. Because early on I played a lot of Eve, and Eve benefits from the Horror Babylon play, as you can expect, is usually made easier by simply not having any red hearts in the first place. So there are a couple of items that benefit from not having any red hearts at all, and there is one item that benefits from having exactly one, so that's interesting. So I usually look at red hearts as fodder for the deal with the devil, because it has such a... well, I say such a good chance. It has a chance, which is not... it's a non-negligible amount of opportunity to give us a strong benefit for getting rid of that HP. So I always try to do so, even when the run is in no real position to immediately benefit from it. Yeah, yeah. Suck it. Yeah, so that turned into the monster manual. But it also turned into stats, so I don't think we absorbed Monster Man Quail, but we absorbed the stats. We absorbed the shitty item that we don't want. It's nice to see those stats. I mean, I know I went on about it, and to some extent I still agree with what I used to say, which is that not knowing exactly what your stats are is kind of nice, right? We took a quarter, I think it's worth more points than it's unworth. I still stand by that to some extent. It's not entirely... without merit to suggest that maybe we want to have some mystery left in the old game. But at the same time, knowing when your all stats upgrade is going to give you all stats up, or when it's going to disappoint you by giving you only HP that you don't really want, or being able to see quite how bad a stat upgrade actually turns out to be. Oh, bombs again. Excuse me for weirdly hiccuping like that. I am trying to explode one of these near what I'm hoping will turn out to be the small rock. But I'm not going to try too hard. It was a golden chest that is then a red chest. Very well. I'm looking for another opportunity to void something. I could have voided the SMB Superfan if I wanted to, but I think we got more stats out of it than we would have got if we'd voided it, and I don't mind the HP, as mentioned. I have a propensity for trying to get rid of my HP or to shy away from something that's going to give me HP, but it's not actually costing us anything to have it right now, which I think is quite important in that regard. We want to get out of here because, you know, I've not been playing slowly, but I've not been playing quickly. And that backtrack that we just did there, mostly because some part of me was trying to say that there was a item to suck and there wasn't, has cost us a little bit of time. And unfortunately, we fought greed in both shops on the Necropolis. So, actually, we're on the Depths 1, so we only fought greed on the Caves and the Depths 1. So there is one more shop, which is, I guess, good. Monstro 2 is a non-guaranteed item, so hopefully we get something that is not a Tears upgrade, because we're at a Tears cap, but is a damage upgrade, rather. Which is basically all I want right now, is a damage upgrade. My speed is fine, even though it says it's not. Which is something that I found odd, or at least a curio, is I'm not quite sure whether all characters move at the same rate when they have the same speed stat. Because I've noticed sometimes when I've got 2 speed, I'm feeling very sluggish. And other times when I've got 1.4 speed, like right now, I'm feeling, you know, quite quick. It is a Tears upgrade, of all things. And we can take both of these, and I think that we actually probably should. We'll take Dark Bum. Dead Cat costs nothing. We'll take this. We'll take this. See if it actually gives us anything. It is a shot speed upgrade, which has some value. Maybe I should have avoided that. Would you have sucked that? I think I would have sucked that. I tell you what, though. We can reroll a deal with the devil before we pay for it. I hadn't considered that. So that is worth at least remembering. Amnesia at this stage is pretty... not fly. No. Pretty bad. I didn't really want to have to pick my way through this room. This floor without knowing where I'm going, but so be it. We are now down to 1 HP. Waffling on about not having any HP, and then we go ahead and find something like this. Now I, okay. Do have 9 lives, but I am reluctant to suck this item up. I hope it's obvious why. Although it will kill us in 3 seconds after I use it, and that will be okay. It's probably not worth it, because if I'm going to suck something up, I want to get the statistical benefit of it. I can't reroll it. I can't use the suck to reroll it, because it's an active item. Which means it will be absorbed into our void, and then immediately used. Now, I think it will only last one use. I think it's one of those ones that goes away, much like Pandora's box. But I could be wrong, so every time we use the suck in future, it could end up killing us, so I'm not going to take it. I'm not even going to risk it. We have a minute, basically half a minute to find the mom fight, or we're not doing boss rush, which does bother me. Yes, thank you for asking. How are we going to do this? We're going to go really, really fast and hope for the best. And we're probably not going to do the deal with the devil if we get one, because it's very likely to be Krampus, and I'm not going to make that mistake. If we have the opportunity to get to boss rush, do you know what? We do have Dark Bum, though. So if we're likely to get any form of... if we're going to die, basically, if we want to use Plan C, we can get Dark Bum to help out, basically, is what I'm suggesting. Excuse me? That was my only bomb and it failed? I am astounded by this revelation. I would like a teleport card that brings me back into the world, please, so that I can find Mom, and then come back. We found it, so we should be able to manage it. If we can just get through this particular room without taking forever. I don't mind getting hit, because... Alright, we didn't find the item room, I don't care. Basically. We have a few seconds to beat Mom. I think we can do it, especially with these fires helping. But I'm not entirely certain. We might not make it, and that is a bit of a shame, because it was entirely my own fault for backtracking so much. Should not have done it. Yeah, we're not going to make it, so... Well, I guess we fight Hurst and hope for the best. Mom is actually surprised... What hit me just now? Excuse me, please. Surprisingly tanky. We are going via the... We are going via the cathedral, which I actually mentioned earlier might be the case. So there's that. Prick fly is fine. I'm kind of tempted to take the burnt penny, and I'm appreciating the fact that we have permanent Polaroid invincibility before coming in here, because I can really give this guy as much as I need for him to have. We'll take the Whore of Babylon, and I think we'll take this as well. We have so much... Do you know what? I should have used a strength card to do that. That was my mistake. We have so much... opportunity to get HP back, but I really don't mind taking the Whore of Babylon. Paying for the Sack Dagger is what I was saying there, but I definitely should have used a strength card to do that, but that's okay. We can still use it in future, because there will be another deal with the devil. I have faith. Of course, we have Holy Mantle as well, so the chances of us, you know, taking so much damage that we lose this run is basically unthinkable. I know I said the chances are unthinkable. Honestly, zero chance is quite thinkable. In fact, it's the easiest chance to think about. Oh, well. It's the easiest to conceptualize, that's for sure. Don't know if it's the easiest to think about, because if you, like... If it's your chances at a romantic interaction with a potential beau, then maybe it's difficult to think that you have zero chance of such a thing. But if it's a chance of losing a run, then it's very nice to have zero chance. And right now I'm wondering if we actually have zero chance of ever becoming Guppy, even though every single chest that ever drops is a Guppy opportunity. Question marks is something's wrong. Well, that just makes baddies slow. It's like a slow version of Lemon Party. It doesn't last as long as Lemon Party somehow. Tears down. Well, that didn't actually reduce our tears, which kind of implies that our tier stat is less than 5, but the tier cap is forcing it back to 5, so... Maybe that's what happens there? I honestly couldn't tell you. Worth the research. Get back to me if you find out. Because I'm not going to do the research. We can, in fact, use the strength card on a single room and not lose the Whore of Babylon, because you only lose the Whore of Babylon when you leave a room, at which point we'll lose the red HP that would have cost us the Whore of Babylon in the first place. So if we wanted to, we could think about using the strength card on the Hush fight. I'm trying to improve our chances that way. I don't know if we have a great chance at beating Hush, especially with 9 lives. But I think it's just going to be one of those things you've got to try, because if you don't, then you ain't going to be in it to win. I don't know. I mean, again, we're not in it to win it. We're in it to win 5 in a row. So we are in it to win it, but we're in it to win the... Oh, right. We got the tarot cloth ages ago. So when we use the strength card, we'll actually get 2 HP and even more bonus damage, I expect. Oh, I got hit. Wasn't a good idea. Wasn't on my agenda, but it happened. So I'm thinking maybe we don't do Hush and we accept the fact that we're not going to rank well in order to have beaten this run. I mean, I'm fairly confident that I could beat Hush like this, especially with Dark Bum on my side. Especially if we have full HP when we go in there. We do have enough money and enough keys. Well, we're not going to get anything out of the golden chests because they're going to be red chests, which are constantly giving us nothing of value. Can't help but notice. Third pretty fly, maybe. A tears down, no. See what I mean? Even the ones that give us pills are not giving us the greatest pills. Something's wrong may help against Hush. It may just be trash. Apparently it's a good pill. But there are better pills. I mean, it's not in the running for please mate PhD remove this from the rotation type of bad, but it is in the why is this in my hand sort of bad. Yeah, I wouldn't want to keep it. We have to make it to the Hush fight, of course. Thank you. Oh yeah, Dark Bum. You can have that. Sweet. Didn't need it. So, whatever, bro. I don't need your charity. I need your charity. I do need it now, though, so thanks for dropping it ahead of time. The pentagram is absolutely fine. We have Leviathan now, so we can get things that we wanted. And that gave us black hearts anyway, so we don't need that. Okay, cool. Moving on. Moving swiftly on. Did we fight the... Yeah, we did fight the room. Boss trap room contains red chest guppy, please. Not a single guppy item since we got the 9 lives. From a deal with the devil, I might add, not from a red chest. Just die. Okay, good. I mean, I kind of expect you to, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, hit me. Stop trying to hit me and hit me. See if I give a shit. Dark Bum's got my back anyway. More to the point, Holy Mantle's got my back, so you can hit me as many times as... Well, you can hit me once. Shame on me. But that doesn't count as damage for the damage penalty, or blood for the blood penalty. Base beat, no? Okay. I think it was worth a penny to see if there's anything in there that could have benefited us. Whatever that could turn out to have been, I honestly don't know. Does... No, it doesn't. I was thinking, does Leviathan give you spectral tears, but it's not quite Spirit of the Night. Level of... I want to reroll it, that's the thing. You can only reroll stuff you haven't paid for yet. Otherwise, you end up sucking it up. Please. Screw it, we'll suck it up. It rerolled into technology as well. Maybe one of the things that would have improved this run is to not have taken the void. Just suggesting that, maybe. Because I didn't realise until far too late that I'm a complete noob and that I can't use the void to reroll items without sucking them up. So, yeah. Live and learn, I guess. Chalk it up to experience and don't do it again. I think I will probably do the Hush fight. Because I suspect we will make it. That doesn't seem particularly in question right now, but... Bit of concentration. Oh, went into that. Look how much HP they have to take that much sack dagger time. I do want to rank okay-ish, if possible. You know, it's not completely my intention to be absolutely the worst player in the whole daily. I'm just kind of afraid of losing the fourth one in a row to a rash decision. But I don't think it's a rash decision. I think with Holy Mantle and Dark Bowman, if we can get Gimpy, then we're basically guaranteed to win the Hush fight, right? So if we get Gimpy, I will do Hush for sure. If we don't, we will see where we stand at the time. If I get Guppy, I will do the Hush for sure. The luck upgrade is okay. I will gulp my trinket for sure, because that is also a luck upgrade, and I think it gives us more keys. The keys aren't really going to help, because we're going to be doing the chest, and we're not going to get any chests on the chest, because we accidentally gulped the left hand, which I probably should have dropped. But okay. I wanted Guppy stuff, right? Can't hardly blame me for keeping the left hand when we get it very first thing on the run. Can't horribly blame me. Guppy, please. Thank you. I will use it once, and then I will suck it. That did drop a bomb. Do be careful, 007, because you have a bomb in your OP item of all things. Guppy, please. Yes, I will pay for it. You cannot stop me. In fact, I should pay for it. Apart from the fact that I said if we get Guppy, we will do the Hush fight. But there's so much HP on the ground now. Balls of Steel, no. Look up, yes. That we can basically recover the majority of the... Oh, wow, okay. HP that we just spent just by running around, backtracking slightly. I think that's enough. We do want to get to Hush. And there is certainly enough HP left on the ground to completely refuel us. But I'm not that concerned now that we are Guppy. So basically all that can make this better is a... What am I saying? Is brimstone or something like that. Something that does a lot of sustained damage in order to produce as many flies as possible. But we're not going to get that because we've already seen our deal with the devil. Entirely by accident, but... You know, I was going on about how it's sad to hear that you have zero chance at Guppy, and lo and behold, we got a full chance at Guppy. So that's really weird. I don't like it. But we're going down here. We're not going to do Void because it's more points to get to Mega Stan than it would be to get to the Void Floor and beat Delirium, because the Void Floor is kind of a little bit lackadaisical in many respects. Of course, there's a good chance that we... really? There's a good chance that we... I mean, we should have picked it up and put it back down, right? Honestly, we could use it against Hush. I'm very, very tempted to. I think we take the Fly item here. I am super, extremely, very, especially tempted to. So that's one spirit heart. I think we might do. Because it will kill us, but we will come back to life with one HP. So we take this. Yes. Yes, let's do it. I've not used Plan C before. And I really, really think that we should. So I'm actually kind of glad that I didn't pick it up and put it back down again when we saw it last time. And our range stat is amazing. So this half of the fight should be fine. And then we're going to use Plan C on Hush to guarantee that we get through it. I assume that it will cost us tremendously. So you die. Wow, that's gross. And then we die. And then we get our Void back and some HP. Now I feel slow. That's interesting. Why has that happened? We still have the Strength card, so we can always recover one more red HP if we want to. Ah, we're slow because we've actually lost the Horror of Babylon effect. Forgot about that. But one thing we can do, actually... HP? No. If we find a way, we can use the Strength card to give ourselves a red HP. Hurt ourselves... such that we take away the red HP but not the spirit hearts. And then, that was very nice, get ourselves to half a heart, which will give us back permanent Polaroid invincibility and the Horror of Babylon. So we did nerf ourselves slightly, but at the same time we did get to use Plan C and one shot the Hush. And now we're doing really well on time as a result. So I think any penalty we get for dying, even though we did it to ourselves, we did, and that's what really hurts, will be more than made up for by our time bonus, I expect. Don't quote me on that. And I didn't suck up the Void, so the Plan C, so I'm not scared to use the Void in future. I mean, obviously we could get a Joker card or something like that to sell this last piece of HP as well if we do well enough. And if this is a reroll, I will reroll. This is everything reroll. Okie dokie. Well, put your money where your mouth is. We'll still be Guppy afterwards. We're also Beasley Bub. We haven't got Dark Bum anymore, but we've got more HP. 2020 itself, so we didn't need to... Oh, God. We didn't need to worry about the Puckworm transformation after all. We might as well take Anarchist Puck. We're super duper slow. Honestly, I'm not going to do that room, and the reason I'm not going to do that room is that it scares me. I think we have $3 bill, judging by the way our tiers are changing infrequently rather than on every tier. We have the Lard item, which is why we have some HP, but not much. And we have replaced our one orbital fly with two orbital flies, the other two, in fact. Sad Onion is probably scuppering our shot speed. We can get into there, but we don't need to. There's nothing in there. We're already Guppy. This is a bad reroll. Don't get me wrong. We do have the Mind, which I'm a fan of. Yeah, I think we take this. We've re-rolled out of Horror Babylon, but presumably not the Polaroid. And apparently we have not re-rolled out of the the left hand being part of our entirety of everything. So, Isaac, fine. We could Anarchist Cookbook this Joker, see what happens. You know, what's the worst that could happen, etc. Try and make some use of little Gertie here. Can't tell which tiers are mine, because apparently we've gone back to base stats. We have actually gone back to base damage. We've re-rolled out everything that was giving us a damage boost. Ah, fuck. What? Don't talk about that moment. We don't want people to... Don't want to draw attention to it, you know? Like the fly in the suit. Everyone will want one. Somehow we managed to make it through that fight. I'm not going to go back to get that secret room. I just want to win, which is looking less and less likely because, of course, we have to beat Mega Satan and not Blue Baby. And we're not going to get much more than Spirit Hearts out of the chests on the chest because they're all going to be red chests. I think we try the secret room. Yeah, definitely try the secret room because... Excuse me. Kicking my bombs around. Okay, that might help. I think we just try. We were doing okay damage just now. I mean, we beat Isaac pretty fast, even though we only have 3.5 damage, which is insane how fast we beat Isaac, considering we only have 3.5 damage. But we do have Guppy, so the fly is certainly helping out to a considerable degree. Our speed is sufficient that... Our speed is at that point where you're too slow to reactively dodge, but the fine control that you get over... your movement means that you can get between bullets without accidentally overstepping them, which is nice. I do often find myself walking into one bullet while trying to dodge another, so in this situation, I think we're okay. Should we have re-rolled? No. No, we absolutely should not have re-rolled. thank you for asking. But, you know, I did cheese up the Hush fight. I don't want to be the sort of person who completely cheeses up the Hush fight and doesn't atone for it in some other way, you know? We deserved to lose. I mean, I should have lost on the Hush fight, basically. Or at least it was... The Hush fight was too risky, considering our goal is to win this run, not to be on the top of the leaderboard, but at the same time. Completely cheating up the Hush fight by spending an entire life just to... basically a free life, considering we're now back at full HP again. Oh, we don't have Holy Mantle anymore, don't forget. So, do watch out for that. I think this is a suitable compensation for me having just decided that Hush was not worth my time. We could have used Plan C right here, but I suspect it would only have done one half of the fight, to be honest with you. And we are doing fine. We've taken one hit. Excuse me. Excuse me again. Why am I still making fire? Don't get me wrong, I appreciate it. It's really helping. But it looks like the ghost pepper was not re-rolled out. I do tend to say my words a little bit funny sometimes. Do I not? Yes, I do. No, I don't like... I'm not really much of a fan of my reflection. Thank you for asking. Right, stage one is done, and that's the one with the annoying enemies. Honestly, Megastan himself... Not that big of a deal. I mean, don't lie to me. Is it fair to give a cat catnip treats and then kick him out for the night? What does catnip do to cats? Does it send them into a weird state where they don't know what the fuck's going on? Because he did seem to have a little bit of trouble, oh god help, with recognizing where one of the treats actually was after he'd had a few. So, is it like alcohol? Or, you know, crack? I don't know. What does it do to them? Alright, we won. We're the best. Pick it up, put it down. Give me that. Thank you. I didn't want to do the rest of the floor because it's just going to be so difficult. 1600th! I mean, we got the rush bonus, but we didn't get the other rush bonus. So we lost 4,000 points just for not doing boss rush. But, you know, we didn't do it. Tis what it is. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope that you'll join me in the next episode, which is actually going to be a previous episode because I've already recorded a lot of them. And I think that's 4 of the 5 that we need to do. So in next daily, hopefully we will win and unlock whatever lame, boring thing it is that we get for doing that. But until then, thank you for watching this episode, and I hope to see you then.